Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about nested routing. When I say nested routing means router inside a router. So till now we were creating these plain routes. If you look at it, we are creating the teams, items, home. These are plain routes, level one routes. What if in the teams I wanted to create another routing level? Like in the team component, if I wanted to render another set of routes, something like this, here in this, instead of returning this in the render function, if I return ULLI and here we can just actually render teams team 1, it can be a team 2 and team 3. Okay, this you can match.url, or you can also hard code it with whatever the URL you are getting. So what URL we have is teams and team 1. You can just change it to team 1. I will just copy paste it so we can get it quickly. Team 1, team 2, team 3. And here is our team 1. Okay, so this is how we can achieve the routing. So whenever this teams component is getting rendered, we should be able to see these different routes. If it is not dynamic, then you can create simply like this in the two tags. So what we wanted to achieve is we wanted to pass this team name as a route parameter. So we just need to create one route. One common route can be there because these are all are dynamic, but the base route is same. So what we will do in our main router, we will be passing this route parameter. So in the app.js, in the teams, let's call it as a teams, because we will have multiple teams and based on one particular team. So in teams, we can actually pass the team name. Right, this team name can be used as a route argument, and in the component we can get the team name value. So if team name is team 1, team 2, team 3, then we will be able to capture it. So here team child component, you can see for this particular component we are going to render team child, and instead of team component we can create a team child. So here we have a team child component. Team child component will receive what is actually in the props. We are passing this team name and based on that it will render. You can just copy the same thing which we have. So we can copy this team child, and here we can actually grab what is being passed in the props. So here is team name is so here you can just create a h1 tag, and inside that you can wrap it around, and team name you can get which will be coming from, so this dot props dot match. So this you will access, and inside match you have params, and in the params we are getting passing team name. So this is how we'll get it. So team name is we are passing here, same argument you have to pass team name. So this team name is available in the match.params.teamName, right? And we are able to get it. So here is a team child component, and here we are able to get it using this dot props dot match.params.teamName. It's very long, but in the match we are accessing from the prop, so we have to write this dot props dot match. Okay, so this is how we will be actually doing the nested routing. Now whenever you are clicking on one of the team name, so for teams, team component is rendering, which is having these three different links, teams, team 1, team 2, team 3. So whenever you are clicking on to the exact component, this will be receiving this. Okay, so what we are doing is link is not defined, so we can import link from react router DOM. here it is not a talking about link, we are not even using it. So in app.js, where it is complaining, src-team.js. Okay, teams, team 1, team 2, team 3. So when I click on it, teams, okay, it should be teams. So we in the header, we just need to change it to teams, otherwise it is going to 404. So teams, now if you click on team, right? Now we are on the team 1 component. Similarly, when you click on team 2, I'm just naming is different, but this is like this, team 1, team 2, team 3. We are able to render the nested components. So from parent component, we are able to access the child component. And the, for debugging, we have to look into the props which we are receiving from the parent component for these nested components. So you can see here, this is route home component, and here if I see teams, you see the, this is, inside this we are getting these components. So it is actually talking to this particular link, team 1. So when I'm clicking on to team 1, it is actually accessing this particular path, okay? And it is having, we are able to access this from the match, match.params.teamName, you can see. This is what we are accessing in the component. This dot props dot match.params.teamName, which is coming as team 3, right? So this is how we are actually accessing the props and getting the route parameter. Here route parameter is team 3, similarly team 1, team 2, we can access the same thing. Okay, thanks everyone.